A multi-billion dollar investment by Ford into a Windsor, Ontario engine plant is off the table. Unifor says that investment meant 1,000 new jobs in Windsor. The workers would have made small fuel-efficient engines and possibly even hybrids. Besides more jobs, the investment had been called a game-changer. The reasoning went, if small engines could be built profitably in Canada, other investments might follow. In 2000, nearly 172,000 Canadians worked in the auto industry, including those assembling cars and manufacturing parts, and it was trending higher then. Well, less than a decade later, fewer than 110,000 remained as the recession took its toll. The latest numbers from 2 years ago show only a fraction of the lost jobs bounced back. Jerry Dias is the president of Unifor. Great to have you with us.
Great to be here.
I want to start with what happened here, because there was really conflicting reports. You had Ford saying, we can't walk away from a commitment we never made, whatever that means. The federal government saying these terms were unacceptable to us, whatever that means. And the Ontario government giving a kind of a strange answer, saying we invest a lot in this industry and we'll continue to do so. What went wrong here?
Well, this was a program that was originally earmarked for Mexico. So we were trying to steal the program.
Right.
The engines are going into assembly plants predominantly in Mexico and the southern United States. We got involved with Ford a couple of months ago trying to wrestle it here to Canada for our Windsor plants. We brought together the governments. We gave it our best shot.
And why did we not win it from Mexico?
Well, there was a very heavy ask from Ford, and there was heavy asks from both levels of government. We thought we were getting there, but we just couldn't get past the final hurdle. So
is this about money? Did Ford want a dollar investment when the feds say we found the requirements unacceptable for taxpayers? I interpret that as it was too much money.
Yes.
Do we know?
The governments would say that the amount of the ask was more than the commitment at the end of the day. So I'm frustrated because we understand that it was 1,000 direct jobs, but there's another 8,000-9,000 indirect jobs. And bringing small engines to Canada is a game changer. That would have absolutely changed how the Canadian automotive industry is viewed. So it is a significant loss for us.
One of the things that this really underscores is we are losing other manufacturing to Mexico. Mexico is doing something we're not. What is it that they're doing, in your view? What are they doing differently or better, or what's different about what's going on there?
Well, their manufacturing footprint has gone from 14 to 19% in the last few years, and we've gone from 16 to 14%. It's simple. The Mexican government is absolutely determined that they're going to bring manufacturing to Mexico. And so it really has to do with government policy, and it has to do with them being incredibly aggressive. And so they are being much more aggressive than Canada when it comes to attracting work.
Jerry, some people would say we made an investment in this industry in the credit crisis as part of a North America-wide bailout. And part of the understanding was we were doing it because jobs would stay. And there's a little sense of betrayal that that didn't actually pan out as well as people thought that it would. Jobs went. The big three do take jobs, not just to Mexico, but to southern U.S. states that have right-to-work legislation, cheaper production, in other words. Mm-hmm. So there's a kind of a sense that are we throwing good money after bad? We didn't get the guarantee of jobs we thought we were getting last time.
Well, it's not correct. Actually, since the recessions, there's been about 15,000 jobs created here in Canada. So you're right. We are less than 110,000, but there has been an absolute shift to the positive. There's been major investments made with Chrysler in Windsor, major announcement just with Ford, another 1,000 jobs. GM has made a major announcement at CAMI. So there are announcements being made and investments being made. But unfortunately, we're going to zero in on the one that got away from us, which is in Windsor.
In this case, the government chose, they didn't like a variety of things, presumably, but they didn't want to make the dollar investment. Why should governments invest? Why should governments pay tax money to get jobs for some citizens? Why not let businesses decide where to invest based on the most efficient place to do business?
Well, because if we leave it to the business community, there won't be any jobs here in Canada. This is simple math, and that's why, here's why governments seek auto jobs. The Ontario government in the last 10 years have invested about $85 million a year on average. For their $85 million, they've got $2.4 billion worth of GDP. So it's easy. That's why companies are all and countries are saying, give me the work, because the return is so significant. So it's a winning strategy. Auto is the number one export industry for Ontario, for Canada. And it creates a heck of a lot of jobs.
Are we less productive than manufacturers elsewhere?
No.
Do we manufacture less productively? That's the complaint we hear.
No, just the opposite. I mean, you will find that Canada bats well above their average. We win more awards for competitiveness, productivity.
In this one sector?
In the auto sector, yeah. Absolutely. I'm talking about the auto sector.
So would you extend, in your view, that same idea of attracting business by governments investing to other sectors? Or should we be doing that same thing where tax dollars support industry to bring it here?
Yes, but I think we also need a much broader strategy that says we're our strengths in Canada. We're rich in natural resources and raw materials, but we don't utilize that to put young people to work. We'll build pipelines that'll ship our jobs overseas as opposed to building refineries here in Canada. We've closed 10 refineries. Why wouldn't we reopen it? Why wouldn't we sell finished products? So there's a lot of different ways that we should be talking about building our economy, but clearly government has to play a role.
And do you have a sense or do you even know whether this was the federal government that in the end couldn't stomach it, or the provincial government, or both?
No, I think it was all three. I think Ford had a heavy ask and the governments were expecting heavy commitments as well. So just, they couldn't find the middle ground.
Jerry, great to have you here.
Always nice to be here.